Shalom, shalom. We're coming back with another sit down, man. And first and foremost, we want to give all praises and infinite honor unto the heavenly Father and His Son. And to go by the name of Yahweh, by Shem, Yahweh Shai, by Shem, Rakakwadash. Once again, we'd like to give double honor to the elders, apostles, great millstone, and salutation and blessing to all the Akim pushing this work in truth and sincerity, man. You know, once again, man, hey, it's the holiday season, quote unquote, you know, because, you know, tomorrow is what people would ignorantly call Christmas, man. You know, which we know in its ancient form as Saturnalia, you know. And we understand that a lot of these holidays, man, they are pagan, man. So we just wanted to go ahead and get a couple scriptures on just how these holidays, man, they're worthless, basically, man. They were made, they're man-made, and they're basically vain, man. They have no substance, man. They have no real purpose, man. All it does is just take the minds of the people and put them into a folly state, huh? You know?
The Most High gave those heathens over to those those paganistic ideas is just to give them something to do.
That's it.
But you Jakes are the ones that have the true understanding of how this world works, but yet you want to fall into the ways of these heathens. That's why you're in the situation you're in right now.
That's right.
This is Isaiah 45 and 16. They shall be ashamed and also confounded, all of them. They shall go to confusion together. It's like it. They shall go to confusion together that are makers of idols.
That's right, man. And a lot of you Jakes have made these different holidays idols, man. You have idolized the Christmas tree, man. You have idolized these costumes on Halloween Day, man. You know, you idolized that damn turkey on Thanksgiving or that ham, man. You have basically, you're put them in worship form, man. How often you gotta get it done, man? How forceful you gotta make it to these stores, man, and make sure I gotta do this and make it like that and make, you know, like it's just idol worship, man.
And more often than not, a lot of these holidays go back to times when Jakes were killed by their enemies. And it was a celebration for that, and in a modern sense, you making your kids sit under that Christmas tree and open presents, yeah, is you sacrificing your kids up to Nimrod, because that's Nimrod's penis. It's no different than what those heathens used to do back in the day, where they would put their kids on that big bull statue that was on fire and offer them up to the fire.
That's right. And I just wanted to reframe that. You idolize the holiday, man, or basically the pagan deity that is over that holiday, man. That's what you idolize, man. And you don't even have no idea that you're doing it, man. But when you take on to something and don't have no understanding of something, man, all you're doing is just showing reverence to it, man. Because honestly, when it comes down to it, you care less about understanding it, man. So therefore, you're just kindly just going into it, you know, with the understanding of just wanting to show some type of happiness for it, man. You know? You don't have no problem with it. So if you don't have no problem with it, man, it's idol worship.
Come on.
Yeah.
This is Acts 15, verse 19. Mm-hmm. Wherefore my sentence is that we trouble not them which from among the Gentiles are turned to the Most High, but that we write unto them that they abstain from pollutions of idols and from fornication and from things strangled and from blood.
That's right, man. And a lot of those different holidays, man, they were made in a lot of killing, you know, a lot of homosexual activities, man. You know, a lot of those different holidays, man, was basically built on negativity in general, man. You know, wasn't nothing good about them, you know. Like I said, started at 18, huh?
Started 18?
No, it was at 19. Okay. It was wherefore my sentence is that we trouble not them which from among the Gentiles are turned to God. But yeah, I'm just trying to make sure I'm at the right spot. Alright. It says, but that we write unto them that they abstain from pollution of idols and from fornication. And exactly, man. And this is what we preach to the people, man, to stay away from these different things, man. Because these holidays wasn't built on nothing great, man. That's the reason why we say stay away from Christmas, man. Stay away from Easter. Stay away from Thanksgiving. Halloween, man. Because none of these different holidays was built on nothing great, man. All of them have pagan deities that reside over them, man. Go ahead.
I got a precept for it. It's kind of long, but it kind of hits the point. This is in the Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 14. I'm going to start at verse 21. Mm-hmm. And this was an occasion to deceive the world, for men serving either calamity or tyranny did ascribe unto stones and stocks the incommunicable name.
Right.
It's pretty much making those works of the hands of wood and stone as gods. That can't even, as it always says through the scriptures, they can't even hold themselves up. They have to be fastened up because that's how worthless they are.
Kind.
Verse 22, moreover, this was not enough for them that they erred in the knowledge of the Most High.
That's right, man. And when you fall into these different holidays, man, you err drastically, man. When you give reference and when you show love to these different holidays, man, that just shows how much you hate the Heavenly Father, man. Because you don't even think twice about his high holy days, but you can't miss the holidays that Esau set up, man.
Come.
That just shows your lack of empathy for the Heavenly Father, man.
Come. Verse 22, moreover, this was not enough for them that they erred in the knowledge of the Most High, but whereas they lived in the great war of ignorance, those so great plagues called they peace.
And that's beautiful the way they stated it. The great war of ignorance. Because a lot of you people in your minds, psychologically in your mind, y'all warring against understanding, man. Oh, man, that sounds true, but I don't give a fuck. Like, you literally warring against ignorance, man. Like,
you don't have faith.
That's right.
You don't believe in the consequences.
Like, I'd rather do this for the kids. But the kids don't have no money.
Are the kids the parents? Who's supposed to be the adult? This is verse 23. For whilst they slew their children in sacrifices, or used secret ceremonies, or made revilings of strange rites, they kept neither lives nor marriages any longer undefiled, but either one slew another traitorously or grieved him by adultery, so that there reigned in all men without exception blood, manslaughter, theft, dissimulation, corruption, unfaithfulness, tumults, perjury, disquieting of good men, forgetfulness of good turns, defiling of souls, changing of kind, disorders in marriages, adultery, and shameless uncleanliness. Verse 27, for the worshiping of idols not to be named is the beginning, the cause, and the end of all evil.
That's right, man. You know, all that lets you know exactly what this society has brought to you people, man. And by you constantly worshiping these different idols and worshiping these different holidays, all you're allowing it to do is just set it in you, man. You know,
it comes with a certain vibration to it.
It does.
And you've got those demonic vibrations that are getting into you.
True.
And it also doesn't help that on these holidays, what do? You eat and you drink and you get around scantily clad women.
Yeah.
So it only just adds to it. It only exacerbates the issue. As I said, it leads to adultery and disquieting of marriages and perjuries and tumults and corruption, manslaughter and death.
Mm-hmm. And it's sad, man. But hey. For the most part, there's nothing we could do about it, man.
Hey, they love to have it so.
That's right. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get this real fast. It, 2 Corinthians 6 and 14. Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers.
Don't celebrate these holidays. A perfect example of that. We have a brother in the camp. A friend of his came out to the camp a couple of times and stood on the other side, you know, to listen, and he didn't show up for a while, so he had an understanding of the truth enough to come know that he had to come out to get further into it. But a while ago, he went to a Christmas party knowing this knowledge and ended up getting stabbed 13 times,
that's right, man.
5 times in the throat for being, and survived for being unequally yoked.
Yeah. It says, for what fellowship had righteousness with unrighteousness, man?
None. Point blank, period.
It says,
What's a king have to do with a peasant?
Nothing. Can't even be in the same circle. And what communication had light with darkness, man? If we understand that holidays is bad and you don't, well, we're trying to shine light on you and you just trying to keep turning ours off, man, we gotta separate, man.
We gotta keep it going.
We gotta separate. It said, and what concord had Hamashiach with Balaam? Balaam, nothing, man.
And Balaam's, or Baal, is that god that's always referenced in the Old Testament that made our people fall away the most, and that a lot of these heathens were worshiping.
Right.
Baal wanted those children to be sacrificed on his altar.
And it says, or what part had he that believed with an infidel?
None.
And what agreement had the temple of Yahweh with idols? The Lord don't allow you to make it. Why would the Lord allow you to celebrate Christmas in his temple, man? In his temple, man, in his church. If you around us, you're not celebrating no motherfucking Christmas, man. If you are, you got to get from around us, man. You're not a part of us, man.
You're putting the brothers at risk. You're being a cancer to that body, that gangrene that needs to be cut out, because you're for your wickedness and for the brothers being yoked unto you. Who knows what calamities could befall you and also spread on to the brothers.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And it says, for ye are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people, man. You know, and wherefore come out from among them and be ye separate, said the Lord, and touch not the unclean things, and I will receive you, man.
And what is this, these living waters, this living temple the Most High have to do with dead and dumb idols that can't even hold themselves up? They need to be fastened to stay up.
That's right, man. Give me Ecclesiastes 33:7. That's right, man. You got to leave that shit alone, Jake. If you don't leave that shit alone, the Lord have no dealings with you, man. You know? And it says, and I will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my son and my daughter, said the Lord Almighty, man. And honestly, man, when you read the scripture, the Lord don't talk about none of those different things, man. He don't talk about Halloween. He don't talk about Thanksgiving. He don't talk about Christmas. He don't talk about New Year's. He don't talk about none of these different holidays, man. But yet you, Jake, still want to sit here and act like, Oh, the Heavenly Father blessed me with this day. He blessed me with these gifts. He blessed me with this tree. The Lord got you making your daily bread so you can worship him, man. Not so you can worship the so-called white man. Go ahead, bro.
This is Ecclesiasticus 33:7. Why doth one day excel another, when as all the light of every day in the year is of the sun? Is that it?
Let me see. Go keep reading.
By the knowledge of the Lord they were distinguished, and he altered seasons and feasts. Some of them hath he made high days and hallowed them, and some of them hath he made ordinary days.
Mm-hmm.
And all men are from the ground, and Adam was created of the earth.
Oh, yeah, exactly. But see, read 8 again, Salakia.
By the knowledge of the Lord, they were distinguished.
That's right.
And he altered seasons and feasts.
Right, go ahead.
Some of them hath he made high days and hallowed them.
That's right, man. And the Heavenly Father has hallowed days, man. His high holy days, man. There are days that's not hallowed by the Heavenly Father, man. Like the day that's coming tomorrow, it wasn't hallowed, man. We have a clean distinction through the scriptures that day wasn't hallowed. That wasn't the day that Yahawashah was born on. Now, it may be the day that your Jesus, the white Jesus, was born on, but it wasn't the day that Yahawashah was born on, man. Because the scriptures help us understand that, man, distinguish it, man. And like the scripture said, man, the Heavenly Father hallowed days, man, feast days, man, the Passover, man, the Sabbat, man.
Purim.
That's right, man. What else we got? The day of Atonement.
The Feast of Booths.
You know.
Feast of Tabernacles.
The Feast of Tabernacle. You know. So the Heavenly Father have days that he gave us, man. And we ought to respect that, man.
Hey, and Saturnalia goes back to Rome, and Rome is that beast. So you're worshiping the image of the beast by worshiping his holidays. That's right. A part of that beast.
That's right, man. That's right. You got something?
Oh, no.
Well, give me Jeremiah 10 and 4.
Okay.
Well, 10 and 1.
This is Jeremiah 10, verse 1. Hear ye the words which Yahweh speaketh unto you, O house of Yasharallah. Thus saith Yahweh, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, heathen are dismayed at them.
That's right, man. That's the reason why they made certain things idols, like goddamn trees, man, fir trees, man. The brother, the elder brother, Yashawamba, did a beautiful lesson on the fir tree, man. You know? But what did the heathen do, man? The heathen went and made a goddamn idol out of this tree, man. For you to cut it down and put it in your house, man.
They worshipped it like a god because that tree, it stayed youthful for so long, so they thought of it as some kind of immortal god.
Yeah.
Showing the ways of these heathens are completely vain.
That's right, man. You can go keep reading.
Kind of. For the customs of the people are vain, for one cutteth the tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workmen with the axe.
That's right, man. And that's what you people do, man. You sit up here, and they even got motherfuckers that went and cut plenty of trees and brought them to their little area and selling them, man. Get your tree. I'll pitch in one of them little stands and all that, man. Go ahead.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
Man, the Heavenly Father been knew you motherfuckers, man. The Lord been knew y'all, man. He been knew all of us, man. But you people stand out here and you have these straight ass faces and you got the nerve to smirk and laugh, man. Like the Heavenly Father don't know you, man. The Lord have everything he need to know about you people, man. Go ahead.
They deck it with silver and with gold. They fasten it with nails and with hammers that it move not.
That's right. Go ahead.
They are upright as the palm tree, but speak not. They must needs be born because they cannot go. Be not afraid of them, for they cannot do evil, neither also is it in them to do good.
That's right, man. And that's just what it is, man. The Heavenly Father not dealing with none of that shit, man. The Heavenly Father is a living power, and his son came to rescue his people, redeem his people, man. And he getting it done, man. And everything is going to happen the way it needs to happen, man. We're going to get out of this hellhole, and we're going to be in the kingdom, man. Worshiping the Heavenly Father and doing our high holy days and stop dealing with these pagan days, man.
And you heathens are going to have to do our high holy days as well. If you don't, we're going to send plagues upon you.
That's right. You know? So, Lord willing, man, it will edify. We want to give all praise and infinite honor unto Yahweh,
Ba'ashem, Yahweh-Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakakwadash.
Double honor to the elders, apostles, great millstone, and salutations to all you brothers, man. Shalom.
Shalom.